ओके सो हेलो एवरीवन. सो टुडे आई हैव रिसीव्ड दिस गीगाबाइट H61 मदरबोर्ड. इट्स मॉडल नंबर इज़ GA H61M -S2P. सो फर्स्ट वी विल चेक व्हाट प्रॉब्लम दिस मदरबोर्ड हैज़. सो टर्निंग ऑन माय पावर सप्लाई. ओके आई हैव टर्न्ड ऑन माय SMPS. एज यू कैन सी दिस इज माय SMPS एंड SMPS फैन इज स्पिनिंग एंड स्टॉपिंग. ओके इट इज़ नाउ स्पिनिंग नाउ अगेन स्टॉप. Okay, so it means we have restart condition. So we are going to check its voltages one by one. So we will start from RAM section. So here we have MOSFET. Here we will get 5 volt. Okay, 5 volt is available. Again on source terminal we should get 1.5 volt. 1.5. Okay. Then we have here VCC IO voltage 1.05. 1.05. Okay. Then we have another VCC IO. 1.8 volt it should be 1.8. okay, so it is passed. Then we have VCC SA voltage over here. Sorry, okay, VCC SA or CPU VTT. okay, then we will check for Vcore voltage. Okay, this one is CPU VTT voltage 1.06 volt. So let me check for Vcore. Here I think I will get 12 volt as input on this MOSFET. Okay, sorry, on this MOSFET we will get 12 volt input. I think I have not connected properly. I am not getting 12 volt. Okay, so let me check over here first. Okay, this is input. Okay. Sorry, this is okay. As you can see here I am getting 12 volt as a input. This is our primary MOSFET. On source terminal I should get 1 point something voltage, so I am not getting voltage anything. So we have here VRMIC on pin number 9. I think pin number 9 is connected to this resistor. So let me check voltage on this resistor. Okay, I am not having any kind of voltage on this resistor. Let me show on pin number 9. Okay, on pin number 9 also I am not having any kind of voltage. So let me switch off first. Okay, right now we are going to trace pin number 9. Okay, the signal actually in this motherboard we have VTT power board as a input to this VRMIC as a animal signal. So let me connect one probe to pin number 9. Okay, I have connected. Here we have some mini MOSFET over here near RTC section. So we are going to check one by one to its drain connection. Okay, I think we have connection over here. So let me check this MOSFET first with source. Some more, I am getting some water reading, and we are going to check voltages. Is there any kind of voltage available on gate? That's why its VTT power board is voltage is grounding. Okay, as you can see after turning on this we have here 5 volt voltage. That's why this upper VTT power board signal is being grounded. So one thing which we are going to do, we are going to remove this MOSFET and check whether our problem is solved or not, because right now we have restart condition. So for that I am going to remove this MOSFET and let's check whether our problem is resumed or not. one more thing with this motherboard. I checked it physically. Someone has reprogrammed this BIOS. As you can see, we have flux over here, and someone has removed this both the BIOS and program, and check whether after programming this BIOS our restart issue is solved or not. But I think he have not checked for weak core voltage, because weak core voltage enable is signal is not available. That's why our weak core voltage is not present. I think that's why our motherboard is restarting. But someone has tried to program its BIOS and tried to solve restart issue, but I think he have not seen that weak core voltage is not available. So first of all, whenever you get like this case, check all the voltages, because in Gigabyte this H61 series you get lot of problem due to weak core, VCCSA and CPU VTT. These three sections give lots of problem, and restart issue and no power issue are caused by this. And last one is BIOS. Due to BIOS you can get restart issue. So first you have to check physically, then afterwards you have to go for other problems. Okay, so I have removed this MOSFET, so we will keep it for some time and we will check whether our VTT missing issue, VTT power board, which is actually enable signal for VRM IC, is available or not. Okay, so I think motherboard has been cooled down. So let me connect display. And check. Okay. Turning on my motherboard. One thing which is good, our SMPS fan is spinning. Before that we were getting restart issue continuous. But right now it's spinning well, and I think display is also available. Okay. Processor is also heating. It means that we have our weak core voltage, which was missing. Now it's available. Okay, we will check first display on keyboard, because my monitor is having a little bit problem. Okay. ओके आई थिंक मॉनिटर पावर एलईडी इज ग्लोइंग बट नो डिस्प्ले एंड सेम ऑन दिस ऑल्सो आई डोंट हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ डिस्प्ले सो लेट मी ट्राई टू चेंज रैम एंड चेक वेदर वी ओके आई थिंक इट्स न्यू रैम बट देन ऑल्सो we are going to change it and check whether our display is available or not okay same condition no display on keyboard One thing which I want to show you here I have this power LED of this screen it is glowing as you can see but no display on screen and on keyboard also so one thing someone has reprogrammed this BIOS as you can see both the BIOS have flux on it so it may be due to wrong flash file So first thing which I am going to try, just swap this BIOS from this BIOS to this place, and let's check whether our display is available or not. Before that, we will remove CMOS and check for display once again. Same case we don't have a display and same monitor's power LED is blinking means okay try to clear CMOS but same issue still okay so we are going to try to swap this BIOS first and then we will check further why we have no display condition okay one thing which I can do instead of programming BIOS I have same similar board reversion also is similar so I can swap directly BIOS from here and place over here because we have to cross check this BIOS file instead of doing that we can directly swap from this board and we can place over onto that board so I have this scrap board apply some flux This is main BIOS. let me place main BIOS on its place. Okay, I have removed backup BIOS also. Okay, just place here. So we have changed, swapped BIOS from this board to this board. So we will keep it for some time so it will be cooled down to room temperature, then we will check. So we have removed this MOSFET over here because of after removing this MOSFET our weaker voltage has generated, and also we have display. Let me show you. Currently our CPU temperature is 61 degree Celsius, our VCore voltage is 1.2 and RAM voltage is 1.5. so it means only we have removed one MOSFET and we have reprogrammed its BIOS, and after doing so our display is available. And on keyboard I don't have this LED because I think we have problem with this keyboard, but as let me show you, my keyboard is working fine. As you can see, I am unable to able to change this setting on all. Okay, so there is no problem with keyboard, but my this LEDs of keyboard are not working. I am pressing caps lock also. Okay, not working. So it may be due to something issue, I don't know, but we have our display. Thank you.